day.
And I just stick this thing in and.
you've driven before, right?
What? We are with Denise Crosby, who is an actress of stage and screen and all things silver.
Heat seekers.
I'm starting to sweat.
Woo!
I love interviewing this lady.
By the way, we can make your butt cooler. She would cool it down. I have wanted to do that, I think, since I first saw that thing floating up in the air. I mean, who wouldn't look at that Goodyear blimp and say, hey, how do you do that?
Yeah, I want to go. Put your trouble down and let me work into. I know this bigger world seems so cold and hard. But baby, don't you worry about a thing, cause I got your heart. Just went and did the Goodyear blimp. Wow.
I mean, that's kind of cool,
it
right?
It was slow and relaxing, but unnerving too, because you're like so pitched.
Yeah, it kind of took me by surprise. I mean, I didn't know what to expect, but I was so confident with this pilot.
And she was like 12 years old.
She was 13.
No, she was 28. Her name is Taylor, and she did a fantastic
Taylor
job.
Taylor is awesome.
She really is. She
awesome.
Really is. So big thanks to Goodyear. That was superb, unexpected fun. You got to go do it.
Yeah, absolutely.
So this is a great start to the episode. They have no idea where we are.
We're lost.
We're just driving in Gardena somewhere.
We've been high for the past couple hours. In a blimp.
In a blimp. And welcome back to 5 Minute Drive. I am Fireball, your host, and today we are with Ken Silk. Ken, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, buddy. Ken is husband to Denise Crosby, who's in the back today, waving. Coolness. Hanging out with Kathy. We're just trying to find how to get on the freeway. I think that this may be it. Don't know. But no, there's a sign.
There's south.
And we're driving a 2005?
2005 Volkswagen Phaeton W12.
Read something where five of these were given to studio executives, I'm not sure which studio it was, to use for a year as a Volkswagen publicity thing. And at the end of the year, the five executives said it was the greatest car they had ever driven.
Wow.
They loved it, it was comfortable, it was fast.
You don't see a lot of these on the road.
You don't. The head of Volkswagen Group, Ferdinand Peisch, wanted to build a car that combined the best of an Audi A8, mm-hmm. the
vest of a Lamborghini, which they also own,
right,
and a Bentley Flying Spur.
Nice.
Volkswagen owns Bentley, and now Porsche.
And so this is a combination of all those?
It's a little bit of each thing. It's hand-built. It's the W12, same as a Bentley, mm-hmm. and it's the transmission and the frame of the Audi A8. And fast-tuned, it's 450 horsepower. He wanted it to be able to go at 183 miles per hour for 24 hours straight. That's what he...
That's a high standard.
That was the standard he wanted on this.
Wow.
I've had it up to 160.
I'd be happy if we got up to 30 just to
now,
find the freeway,
yeah,
because I have no idea... There is a woman eating a burrito over here.
Well, that's,
that tells you that there's food around.
In her car, yeah.
In her maybe. Car. You're a screenwriter.
Yes.
And producer, or
no, no. I mean, I'm whatever I can be. I was an actor for a long time. I went to film school.
Right.
I started acting in New York a long time ago.
We have four people in this car. Each one has a GPS, and none of us know where we're going. It's awesome.
But we don't know how to work them.
Yeah, I can't. I don't know how to see it without my glasses.
I think we've entered a wormhole, and we've landed in Gardena because
I think
there's
we
no
should,
freeways around here anywhere.
I think we should get back on the blimp.
At least on the blimp, we knew where we were going. What do you enjoy writing the most? What kind of screenplays?
I think anything that makes me laugh. And, of course, I'm the only one laughing, so I don't know whether it's...
We always find our stuff the funniest, don't we?
She was on Star Trek, The Next Generation.
Right.
And she goes to conventions all over the world.
And you have the joy of going to them.
Yeah, so we have been literally all over the world.
Right.
Star Trek.
And what's it like for you to watch some of these interesting people at the conventions?
The first
people
time,
like me.
Do you go to the Star Trek conventions?
I haven't been to Star Trek one, but I am going to one in a couple of years.
Are you a Trekkie? Do you
I'm a science fiction nut. Yeah, for sure.
I think the first time Denise took me on a convention, I don't remember where we went, but as we were met in the hotel, the people ushered her away right away, the people putting on the convention, and a very distinguished looking man came up to me and he said, "Excuse me, I just saw you enter with Miss Crosby." I said, "Yes, that's true." And he said, "I need to speak to her immediately." I said, I don't know. She just went over to that other room over there. He said, "I need to talk to her." And I said, "Well, I don't know." And he took out his wallet. I thought he was a cop.
Yeah.
And he said, "I am an officer of the, what's the ship you're on?"
The USS Enterprise.
"And I'm a commander, and
wow,
I need to check in with her." And I went,
okay, all right,
now I know what this thing's about.
Yeah.
So it was
nothing weird
a
about
different
that
world that we stepped into. It was a totally different world than I had ever experienced.
Yeah, yeah.
But very nice people.
But you've transcended now, so you wear the costume and everything when you go, right?
Oh, yeah. But one thing that I remember that really blew me away was that she was drinking out of a cup, and they were having an auction, and the auctioneer came and took her cup and then went up on the stage and said, "I have the cup that Denise Crosby was just drinking out of. What am I bid for this cup?" Which had water in it, I believe. And I said, this is not going to happen. No one is going to bid for it. If they do bid for this and it sells, I have a lot of cups at home. And they bid, and it went up to like, I don't know, $120 that somebody bid to have the cup that she was drinking out of. sometimes after breakfast or dinner, I will go out with a glass or a cup or the fork she used and stand outside our house.
And just
and as cars go by, I will hold it up
on,
and see if anybody wants to buy the fork she just used.
I don't know, but that's kind of like, you know, pimping out your wife's stuff.
That's true. It is. It is. It definitely is.
This is certainly the most unique conversation I think I've ever had.
Hey,
thank you,
make
Ken.
Money whenever you can.